Hello everyone, I hope you all are doing well at home, enjoying your winter break, right? Well, my name is Aarti Rathuri and today we will be studying about air, atmosphere, composition of air and different layers of atmosphere. So, what do you mean by atmosphere? That's right, a huge blanket of air, that is atmosphere. So we can say our earth is surrounded by a huge blanket of air called atmosphere, right? So we have air around us. The atmosphere provides us air to breathe, and apart from that, atmosphere protects us from the harmful rays of the sun, that is ultraviolet rays. You know what, if there would have been no atmosphere, the life would be impossible on earth, because this is the atmosphere which is protecting us from getting baked during the daytime, and we would have got frozen at night if atmosphere wouldn't be there. So atmosphere is a very important thing, and it is one of the reason why a life is possible on earth. So I hope you all have understood that what is atmosphere. Our earth is surrounded by a huge blanket of air, and this huge blanket is called atmosphere. Now we'll learn the composition of air. So in our atmosphere, the foremost or the most the air which is in bulk is nitrogen, that is 78%. See, you know that when we inhale we take some amount of nitrogen, but we exhale it. But the plants need this nitrogen for their survival, and you know what, they cannot take the nitrogen directly from the air. So there is a bacteria, and the name of that bacteria is rhizobium. So what does this rhizobium does? Rhizobium convert, it lives in the soil and roots of the plant, and it converts the nitrogen in the form which is required by the plants. So nitrogen is a very important gas, or we can say it's very important for the plants. It is very useful for the survival of the plants, and in the atmosphere it is 78%. The next foremost important is oxygen. You know that how important oxygen is for us. Oxygen is the second most plentiful gas in the air, in the atmosphere, and human and animals need oxygen to breathe, to live. Green plants produce this oxygen during the process of photosynthesis. When they prepare their food, they produce oxygen, which is then used by the human beings. So this maintain a balance, that plants make oxygen and human beings inhale it and exhale carbon dioxide. The next one is carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide is another important air. Human and this animal release carbon dioxide, and plants inhale that. The plants use them to make food, and this make a perfect balance. But you know what, these days we human beings are burning fuel, industries are creating pollution, and due to which the quantity of carbon dioxide is increasing, that is adversely affecting the earth's weather. And there are two important terms associated with the gas carbon dioxide, that is greenhouse gas. You know, carbon is a greenhouse gas. Carbon doesn't allow the heat of the sun to go out of the atmosphere. This maintains the balance, and that is the reason we are feeling warm, otherwise we would have been frozen. So this is good, that carbon is a greenhouse gas, but too much of carbon dioxide is creating global warming. Global warming, see you how you can understand that when the level of oxygen, this carbon dioxide increases due to factory smoke or maybe by burning fuel, the heat retain and increases the temperature. And you know, the glaciers, snow, all these things are melting, and due to which, what will happen if all these things will melt? The glaciers will melt, snow will melt. In the plain area, it will create floods. So this is called global warming because of increase in the level of carbon dioxide, glaciers are melting, and this is creating global warming. In my next videos, I will definitely tell you about this greenhouse effect and global warming. I hope you have understood the basic of the greenhouse effect and the global warming. Okay. After nitrogen, oxygen and carbon dioxide, another important is argon, that is 0.93%, and the other gases like helium, ozone, hydrogen, water vapors, and of course the dust particle, that is 0.04% in our atmosphere. Now the next, I hope you have understood this. Two important gases which are bulk in our atmosphere are, what are they? Yes, you are right. They are nitrogen 78% and oxygen, that is 21%. Okay, which gas helps in greenhouse, which is called a greenhouse gas? Correct, that is carbon dioxide. It is a greenhouse gas. It maintains the temperature in our earth. Okay, and nitrogen is used by plants for making their food. Carbon dioxide equally used by plants, cannot have nitrogen, cannot inhale nitrogen by themselves directly from the air. So they take the help of the bacteria which are present in the root and the soil of the plant. So I hope you have understood this. Now the another one is very important, not only for the students going to school from 6 to 10, it is equally important for the student who are preparing themselves for the competitive exam. In fact, this is also a very important topic. So let's learn about layers of atmosphere. Our atmosphere is divided into 5 layers, and that is troposphere, stratosphere, mesosphere, thermosphere, and the last one is exosphere. That is the topmost layer, and this is the layer which is closest to Earth. So let's begin with troposphere. See, troposphere is a very, very important layer and the lowermost layer. Why it is important? Because we are surviving on the Earth just because of this troposphere. This layer starts from 0 to 10 and it varies. It is between the, it extends to 10 to 13 kilometers, and the temperature decreases as the height increases. All the weather phenomena, you can see I have made this cloud, so all the weather phenomena happens in this layer, like rain, then fog. There are different types of hailstorms. So all these weather phenomena take place in this layer. Apart from this, clouds are also formed, and the rainfall, fog, hailstorm, as I told you, occurs in this layer. The temperature, see why I said the temperature decreases as we increase, because near the earth it is hot, and as the height increases, it starts becoming cold. So temperature decreases. Apart from this, can you see this one? This is tropopause. So the end of troposphere and starting of stratosphere is troposphere. So let's revise the important lines which we have learned in this troposphere. The first one is, it is the lowermost layer. The second is, all the weather phenomena, lightning, thundering, forming of clouds, rain, hailstorm, everything takes place in this troposphere. Okay, and now let's move on to the second important layer, and that is stratosphere. This is the second layer, second major layer of the Earth's atmosphere. Ozone layer exists in this stratosphere. What is ozone layer? I have already told you that ozone is a very important layer which protects us from the harmful effects of sun's rays. The ultraviolet rays of the sun can harm us, but this ozone layer is protecting us from that ultraviolet rays, from those ultraviolet rays. It extends till 500 kilometers. So it's starting from 10 or 13, it ends till 50 kilometer. The jet, aeroplanes fly here. It is the most accurate place for the jet or the aeroplanes to fly, because there are no weather phenomena, cloud, fog, nothing happens here. It's very clean and clear, and that is the reason, because there is no weather phenomena, that is, it is adequate for the flying aeroplane or jets. The temperature increases due to absorption of ozone gas, because the ozone gas is absorbed here, so the temperature increases with the height. End of stratosphere is stratopause. So from tropopause, see, troposphere ends at tropopause, then stratosphere ends at stratopause. After the end of stratosphere, the third important layer is mesosphere. Above stratosphere lies mesosphere, and this is the third layer of atmosphere. It extends up to 50 kilometers. Here the temperature decreases again. So first temperature decreases with the height, that temperature increases with the height, and here again the temperature decreases with the height. Or you know, you might have seen meteoroids during the night time. So meteoroids burn in this layer. This layer doesn't allow meteoroids to come down to the earth. So mesosphere, see, these are the pictures of meteoroids which I have drawn for you all. So meteoroids burn in this layer. It is again a very important question. Where does the meteoroid burn? So meteoroid burns in the mesosphere. It is the coldest layer of atmosphere, because the temperature decreases, and you know, temperatures decreases to minus 90 degrees Celsius. See how cold this layer is. Carbon dioxide present air also helps in decreasing the temperature. Then the end of mesosphere is mesopause, and after mesopause, the next layer is, the fourth layer is thermosphere. Thermosphere is above mesosphere, and it extends up to 600 kilometers. Thermosphere is the hottest layer, and radioactivity, it is also known as ionosphere, and all the radioactivity, like signals which we send, signals, satellites, radio waves, can be sent and can be retained just because of this thermosphere. The thermosphere helps in sending the waves. According to NASA, as I've told you, 600 kilometer is the height of this this layer. The next point is, it helps in radio transmission and make space communication possible. The next important thing is that the temperature in this layer rises dramatically, and it can reach to 2000 degrees Celsius. In fact, more than that, 2000 degrees Celsius. Imagine how hot this layer is, isn't it? End of thermosphere is thermopause, and the fifth layer is exosphere. So this is the outermost layer. It extends up to 1000 kilometers, and this is the layer where the light gases are present, like helium and hydrogen. So this is the structure of our atmosphere. Let's revise the important points again. First is troposphere. Weather phenomena takes place in this layer. Next one is stratosphere. It has ozone layer, and it is suitable for flying jets or aeroplane, because there is no weather phenomena. Next one is mesosphere. Meteoroids, everything burn here. It is the coldest layer where the temperature goes up to minus 90 degree Celsius. The fourth one is thermosphere, which is also known as ionosphere. It is the hottest layer because it absorbs the rays or the energy of the sun, the heat of the sun, and radio waves, communication transactions are possible through this thermosphere. Last one is the coldest one, that is exosphere, and it extends up to 1000 kilometer. You know, the atomic pressure decreases as we go up. So if we go up, the atmospheric pressure decreases, and so we can say that the atmospheric pressure is maximum at the sea level and minimum as we move up. I hope you all have liked this, you will like this video. Do not forget to subscribe the channel, like the video, and comment. Thank you so much.